covering the Palm Beaches and the Treasure Coast. This is WPBF 25 News at 6.
The Humane Society of St. Lucie County is responding to shocking allegations of abuse. Good evening, I'm Victor Blackwell.
And I'm Tiffany Kenny. Thank you for joining us. A former employee claims that she was fired after she complained about questionable practices.
Kathleen O'Toole has the story, all new at 6. Kathleen.
St. Lucie County commissioners are looking into these accusations as it works to renew its contract with the Humane Society. That's a group that's firing back against the allegations of a former employee.
It's been caring for Treasure Coast animals for more than 50 years. But now the Humane Society of St. Lucie County is dealing with some serious accusations.
I walked in on people euthanizing dogs. They didn't use sedation. The dogs, they're pulling them into the euthanasia room. The dogs know where they're going, and it's just, it was just awful.
Dr. Sarah Matthews says she witnessed these conditions for 4 years as the Humane Society's head veterinarian, but stayed to try and stop them.
Many animals were put down for very treatable conditions, and it might have been that they had heartworms or a puppy stepped in its poop. It was put down for that.
Matthews, who says she had no control over euthanizations, took her concerns to the county commission. That's after she was fired in September, she says, for speaking up.
I've always been taught you try to work up the chain of command. And so that's what I tried to do. But in this case, it just didn't work.
Chair of the Humane Society Board, Annette Miller, says Matthew's story is not true.
Our employees are angry that are here because they feel like it's a reflection on them. We just had a meeting with them, and they're very disturbed because they know that the allegations are false.
Miller says the vet and others are upset about a $2 million satellite facility the Humane Society will build in Port St. Lucie next year.
If they don't have enough money to give animals anesthesia prior to putting them to sleep, then maybe you need to question putting that much money aside for a new building.
Cindy Zudlow of the no-kill shelter Dogs and Cats Forever applauds commissioners' plans to have greater oversight on what happens at the Humane Society.
That's all that we're concerned about, is that the animals are treated properly.
Here's what we're talking about, that greater oversight. The county commission is talking about putting some standard of care expectations into its next contract with the Humane Society. Some other ideas under consideration: a review board that could go in and make inspections, and a tiered compensation system where the Humane Society is paid less if an animal is euthanized and more if an animal is adopted out. Kathleen O'Toole, WPBF 25.